Hello, my dear lovely kids. Today we are going to study the story about two frogs. This is an interesting story. Hope you all will enjoy it. So we are going to start the chapter number 8, the two frogs. Once upon a time in Japan, there lived two frogs. One of them lived in a ditch near the town of Osaka. The other lived in a stream in the town of Kyoto. Kids, this story is about two frogs. One of them lived in a ditch near the town of Osaka and other lived in a stream in the town of Kyoto. Kids, what is the meaning of ditch? Ditch means a long hole dug in the ground. And stream means small river. The two frogs lived far apart, but they both had the same idea at the same time. They wanted to leave home and see a bit of the world. The two frogs lived in Kyoto, wanted to visit Osaka. Soon I shall go to Osaka, he thought. Now kids, both the frogs lived far apart, but one day they both have the same idea. They wanted to leave home and see a bit of the world. The frog who lives in Kyoto wanted to visit Osaka. So he thought, soon I shall go to Osaka. The frog who lived in Osaka dreamed of seeing Kyoto. Oh, I shall leave soon for Kyoto, he said to himself. One fine morning in spring, both the frogs set out. Halfway between Kyoto and Osaka, there was a mountain. Kids, Kyoto and Osaka are the name of the places in which both the frogs live. So the frog who lived in Osaka also wanted to visit the Kyoto. So one day both the frogs went for their journey. It took the frogs a long time to reach the top, but they did so at last. What a surprise it was for each to see the other. They took some rest and began to talk about their journeys. Now kids, both the frogs went out for their journey. Between the Kyoto and Osaka, there was a mountain. So both the frogs went for their journey and they found each other at the top of the mountain. They were very surprised to see each other at the top of the mountain. After taking some rest, they both talked about their journeys on the top of the mountain. I wish we were bigger, said the Osaka frog, for then we could see both towns from there. We could then decide if we want to go on. I have an idea, said the Kyoto frog. Now kids, both the friends want to see each other's town. So one friend was saying, I wish we were bigger, for then we could see both towns from here. They don't want to go down to see each other's town. So they were wishing that we should be big so we can see the towns from the top of the mountain only. So Kyoto folk said, I have an idea. What was the idea, kids? If we stand on our hind legs and hold on to each other, we might see the towns we were traveling to. Could we do that, please? The Osaka frog said it was a very good idea. He put his front feet on his friend's shoulder. Kids, what is the meaning of hind? Hind means back. So they both of them stand together and they hold on to each other to see the town from the top of the mountain. So Osaka frog said, yes, it is a very nice idea. We don't have to go down to see each other's town. We can see each other's town from the top of the mountain only. So they both of them put his front feet on the each other's shoulder. The frogs stood up on their toes, stretching themselves as high as they could. The Kyoto frog faced Osaka and the Osaka frog faced Kyoto. Both the foolish frog forget that when they stood up, their large eyes were at the back of their heads. Kids, you know that the eyes of the frogs are on their back of the heads. So they both of them stand together and wanted to see the town from the top of the mountain. So what happened, kids, after that? So even though they both faced the towns to which they were going to, their eyes saw only the towns from which they had come. "Dear me," cried the Osaka frog, "Kyoto looked exactly like Osaka. Why then make such a long journey? I might as well go home." Kids, the fact about the frog is that they have eyes on the back of their head. So both the frogs were holding each other's shoulder on the top of the mountain. They saw that both the towns look exactly the same. So Osaka frog said that Kyoto looked exactly like Osaka. "Why then make such a long journey? I might as well go home." He said that I should go home, as both the towns were just exactly the same. "If I had known that Osaka was a copy of Kyoto, I would never have came all this way," the Kyoto frog said. And as he spoke, the frogs let go of each other and fell down on the grass, croaking loudly. The two frogs said goodbye politely and wished each other well. Now Kyoto frog also said that, "If I knew that the Osaka is a copy of Kyoto, I would never have come all the way to see the Osaka." And so both the frogs let go each other and fell down on the grass. Then each set off for home again. To this day, they both believe that Osaka and Kyoto, which are as different as two towns can be, look kids. Both the frogs believe that both the towns are same only, but that was not the truth. Both the towns were different. Why this happened? Because they stand opposite to each other, but their eyes on the back of their head. So they thought that both the towns were same only. Kids, I hope you have understood this chapter very well. You have to read this chapter one time at home. Bye-bye. Take care.